The tuning functionality that comes with all Specialized turbo e-bikes is one of the key features of these bikes. But what do the settings mean and what do they do? Well, today I'm going to show you just that, right here on the trails of the French Alps. The tune feature allows you to adapt certain motor settings, thereby changing the performance and feel of the motor to suit your riding needs and environment. If you want to learn how to use the tune feature, check out the existing how-to video on the Specialized University YouTube channel. And if you want to see it used in action, stick around as I'll demo the two parameters that come on all bikes, peak power and support, as well as the additional features that come on bikes like my full-powered Levo, like acceleration response and shuttle mode. To show the effect that the tuning is having on my ride, I've got my Mastermind TCU set up to show the mechanical power output, which is the power coming from the motor, as well as the rider power input, which is the power coming from my own legs. To give a bit of background, the mechanical power is the power that the motor applies to the pedals, and is about 80% of the total electrical power generated by the motor. Peak power allows you to determine the size of your motor in terms of maximum power output. With it, you can limit the maximum power output anywhere between 0 and 100%. So, if you set it at 50%, the motor will max out at about half of its capacity. And if you set it at 100%, you get all the power the motor can offer you. Also, by reducing the peak power, you are effectively increasing the range. To show you what I mean, I'm going to ride up this hill as hard as I can with the peak power set at 100% until the motor reaches maximum mechanical power. Now I'm already at the peak power of the bike, which is the maximum power that the bike's able to give. Now I'm going to set my peak power settings down to 50%. So now you can see I can only get about half the amount of power out of the motor as I did on the previous run, even though I'm having to work a little bit harder. The other tunable feature that comes with all turbo e-bikes is support. Support determines how hard you as the rider have to work in order to receive power from the motor. Set at 100%, you do not have to put in much effort to get maximum assist from the motor. Set at a lower setting like 20%, you'll have to input a lot more of your own power to get the same level of assist as you did with support set at 100%. To demonstrate this, I'm going to ride up the hill again in the standard turbo settings of 100% peak power and support. And just watch how easy it is for me to get to the maximum mechanical output of over 500 watts. So you can see I really don't have to work hard in order to achieve the maximum mechanical power that the motor can give me. So now I'm going to drop the support down to 20% while keeping the peak power at 100%. When I ride up the same stretch of road, it should take a lot more power input for me to get the motor power above 500 watts. So now I have to input a lot more of my own power just to reach the maximum mechanical power that the motor can give me. As mentioned, on certain bikes like the Levo, there are two more parameters that you can tune. Those are acceleration response and shuttle. Let's start with acceleration response. Changing acceleration response determines how fast the motor reacts to your input. I'm going to ride up here a couple of times just to show you how much faster the bike reacts in 100%. So as you saw, setting acceleration response to 100% gives you a much quicker start off the line. But in case you're riding on loose terrain, you may want to reduce this in order to not lose traction. And now for the final parameter, shuttle. Shuttle is basically super support mode. It's the setting you can use when you're tired at the end of the day when you have just one more climb to get over to get home, or it can be used on super steep hills. By increasing shuttle to 100% and with support set to 100%, the motor will provide max power with very little input of your own, especially at a higher cadence. A little warning though, this will seriously drain the battery and reduce the range. But anyway, let's give it a blast at this final climb. So as you can see, I have to input very little power of my own, and the motor is already giving me all it has to offer. I hope you've enjoyed this demo of Tune, a feature that can really elevate your experience when using a turbo e-bike. There are no one-size-fits-all settings though, so I advise you to experiment and find the settings that best work for you. Merci, au revoir.